If you are paying for a Claude subscription, you should be using it to its full potential. With the official Claude GitHub Action, you can now set up powerful automated PR reviews right in your GitHub repository. In my experience, AI reviewers are not as good as human reviewers. They can't test your changes or truly understand the logic, but they are great for pointing out obvious mistakes or accidentally left console logs. I tried to set this up with my $20 Pro subscription, and while it wasn't perfectly smooth at first, I got it working. This video will be your guide to overcoming the small hurdles and getting this amazing automation running in your own projects. So let's dive into the setup. Even though it looks straightforward, there are a few key things to know. First, if you are on the $20 Claude Pro plan, not the Max plan, you have to remember one very important detail. You must specify the correct Sonnet model for every workflow. If you don't, you will get a confusing token cannot be used error. To get started, Claude Code has a great helper command. /install GitHub app. This guides you through the setup automatically. The most important step here is installing the Claude GitHub app on your repository. Without this app, the GitHub action will not work. You can also do this manually by getting a token with the Claude setup token command and adding it to your repository secrets. After the automatic setup is done, you will find a new file in your repo. GitHub workflows claude.yaml. By default, this workflow triggers whenever you mention @claude in an issue or a pull request. Frankly, this default workflow is just a demo and is pretty useless for any real-world tasks. It doesn't give Claude clear instructions, so the output isn't very helpful. Since the default workflow isn't very useful, let's set up something that actually is. For this, I found an awesome GitHub repo called Claude Code Action Ideas, which has some great ready-to-use templates. Let's set up the simple code review action. I'm going to copy the file Claude Code Review YAML into my own project. Now, if you're on the Pro plan like me, this will fail right away. We need to make one small change. We have to tell Claude which model to use. Inside the workflow file, we add the argument for the latest Sonnet 4 model. I'll have the exact model name on the screen for you to copy, but it may change in the future. And to follow the channel's theme, I want Claude to act as the gray cat. A more reliable way to set a persona is to add it to the system prompt using Claude's arguments rather than the main user prompt. Okay, I've pushed the new workflow to my main branch. Now let's create a quick PR. I'll just add some cat emojis to a few strings. The automation was triggered, and after a minute or two, the review appeared. It looks great! If you are finding this guide useful, now would be a great time to hit the like and subscribe buttons so you don't miss future videos. A very useful feature is the full action log. You can see exactly which tools Claude used and its entire thought process. It's also important to know that the action will follow any rules you define in a claude.md file in the root of your project. My claude.md file tells the AI to always check for console log statements, and as you can see, the review followed that instruction perfectly. That simple review is already a huge win, but we can make it even better. The same Claude Code Action Ideas repo has another template called Diff-Aware PR Reviews, which is much smarter. This workflow explicitly tells Claude to fetch the PR's diffs using their GitHub CLI, giving the AI more context about what exactly changed. Because diffs can be large, the example is set to trigger manually, but you can easily change this to run automatically. The prompt in this workflow is very specific. It asks Claude to analyze the diff and produce a concise markdown report. I added this workflow to my repo again with my custom changes for the model and the persona. I ran the workflow and it completed successfully. The final review is concise because my PR was small, but the logs show it did a lot of work. It fetched the diffs, saw the before and after, and also respected my instructions from the claude.md file. Now, I know I've made this look pretty smooth, but things always work perfectly on YouTube, right? When you try it yourself, you might run into errors, so let's go over the common issues I had and how to fix them. First, if you see an error that says Claude Code is not installed in this repository, the solution is simple. Just go and install the official Claude GitHub app. If you get a long API error that says this credential is only authorized to use with Claude Code, that is the model issue. You must specify Sonnet model in your workflow file. If the review is generic and it seems like Claude can't use the GH command, you need to give it permission. Add gh to the allowed tools argument in your workflow. And finally, if you mention add Claude and it reacts with the eyes emoji but never posts a comment, your prompt must explicitly tell the LLM to post a comment using the GitHub CLI. Once you have everything working without errors, there is one more critical topic we need to cover – security. You have to be careful about what Claude can and can't do in your repository. Always follow the principle of least privilege. This means you should only give the action the minimum permissions it needs to do its job. Also, be sure to manually configure which tools and commands it is allowed to use for each specific workflow. With those security best practices in mind, you can start to explore what's possible beyond just PR reviews. In fact, reviews are just the beginning. You can create workflows for almost anything – automatic issue classification, assigning labels, or updating documentation. And if the task is simple, like adding a UI label, you can use a cheaper and faster model like Claude 3.5 Haiku to save some money. Your imagination is the limit. So, what's the final verdict? Automatic AI reviews are not new, but they were often paid or very limited. Using your existing Claude Pro or Max subscription for this adds incredible value. After a bit of setup, you can get automatic reviews, automatic fixes, and even have Claude create new PRs for small issues. But please remember, no AI can replace a human reviewer. Not yet. An AI cannot test your code or understand your true intent. However, it is an amazing assistant that can give you quick feedback on obvious issues before a human reviewer ever sees it. Overall, this is a fantastic addition from Anthropic that opens up a lot of new possibilities. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.